Hello, everybody. Hello, I'm Krasi, Attasio. I have Vanita Lenka again with me, and we're continuing the lessons on Prashna. Vanita spoke about the omens, about touching of the different parts of the bodies. The first syllable, one would say, amazing topics, very applicable for our nowadays. And now the lesson number 8 will be, Vanita just told me, on the formulating the question on before putting the prashna. So please, Vanita, thank you and go ahead.
Oh, thank you so much, Krasi. Yes, this is actually from the point of view of the querent, you know, who's come to ask the question. So what things he should keep in mind when he's to get an unambiguous and a clear answer. So these are the guidelines that I'm just giving you. First thing is that you should be mentally prepared, spiritually prepared, physically prepared to ask the question with good intentions, with clear intentions. So one must breathe deeply, slowly to relax, allow your question to clarify. Because what happens when somebody comes with a doubtful question and is very in doubt and is not clear in his mind what exactly is the question going to be, then the answer also is not clear. So you have to really relax, formulate the question, pray to your Lord, whosoever you worship, then you just so that, you know, whatever the question you're putting, God, please give me strength to put the right question. Let me get the right answer. So that all you have to do. So after the meditation or whatever, you know, if your mind is confused and you're thinking so many things and different questions, that also happens. You don't have to come with one question. I have not seen a single prashna with multiple questions. They will just not come with one question. They will come with multiple questions. So that is something that you have to, even if there are multiple questions, they should be formulated well. So that is something that you have to, be clear on. So if your mind is confused and you're thinking of many different questions, then the chart will reflect your nebulous state of mind and will be exceedingly difficult or even impossible to answer. This can be likened to a woman who gives birth to 5 or 6 children at a time. The survival of any of them is doubtful. As I'm just giving you an example.
But Vanita, people can ask one by one, right? They ask the first question.
I will share that also. That how the astrologer has to answer. Mm-hmm. Because they will come with multiple queries. After this will be multiple queries, how to be answered. So don't ask more than 3 questions in a day. That is something that that's my rule actually. So if you have to, then you can, even if it's 3 questions, you have to wait for at least 30 minutes. Give 30 minutes gap. Don't send them back to back. So it's better that, you know, you're with that break, you will also be able to, formulate the query properly. So then it is necessary to formulate a truthful question in your mind, getting right, you can write down to the fundamentals, what exactly, you want to stick to. So relevant details can be added, whatever, the question that you're asking, the clearer the question, the clearer the answer. So that is also, it's better that you write down, formulate it in a written form. Then don't ask convoluted questions. Keep them as straightforward as possible, please. This is a request to the parents who come to me also, that please formulate your question in a very simplified manner. Don't ask question, what should I do with my life? What type of work should I do? These are very,
yes.
Will I be happy?
But you, Vanita, as astrologer, can you, because this is a sort of magic, so this is very important to ask you. People come and ask you very wide and specific, vague question. Can you, as astrologer, guide them? You say, listen, let's divide your question into 3, or you may do this, right? You're not ruining the spell, no.
No, not at all. Not at all. Because you see, it is not possible that the person who's come so far or who has paid you for over the phone, he's talking and, you know, he will go or he will just let you go, you know, without asking multiple questions. That is obvious, you know, if as it is, you know, these days people want maximum out of less, you know, giving away less and asking for more. So that is something, you know, astrologers are, I think they are prepared for this. So it's fine for me also when I get queries, I just honor those queries. So some ideas might be gleaned for the Prashna, the type of questions that you have been, you know, in. It should be much investigated and, you know, in a natal chart, you know, if you have a natal chart, you can synchronize it with the natal chart. I always want to have, you know, like you could, however, ask a strategic question like, should I go back to school or should I become a lawyer? These questions can be answered through the Prashna also. If you have, definitely, your natal chart and you have the Prashna chart right in front of you, it becomes a lot easier to answer such specific questions also. Remember, Prashna is a microscopic view, whereas natal reading is a panoramic view.
Exactly, so, yes.
So you have to...
The combination of both is amazing. The combination.
It's amazing. So better divide into two questions or more, you know, in separate intervals. That is what I meant. So... And ask positive questions, you know, not in negative. For example, you know, should I visit this or not? That not should not be there.
Oh, yeah.
So if the configuration of question is, you know, positive, I feel the framing of the question, the formulating of question should be in a positive manner. So the answer is also in positive, you know. So the incorrect way is, should I remain at home or not, or visit Mr. X? So that is something, you know, it's so vague and so distorted, you know. So it's like, you know, you should formulate the question well. And you can say in a better manner, should I get into the herbal import business? And if not, then what should I get into? Is it a real estate or should I move back to my country or my hometown? These can be answered. These can be answered, but not that, you know, should I not, you know, so that's something which is not possible.
And honest questions, right, Vanita? Not like, because I had a client who asked me a question which was not correct, lying. Then the answer got totally messy. And this was because...
Right. Yeah. And don't ask the same question, exactly the same question within 3 months' time or 2 months' time, please. Just allow some time to act. Actually, you know, this is something very common, and I'm just giving the practical things what I face. So these are actually in the Prashna mark also, but, you know, I'm just giving it away in the today's era what is happening. Yeah. So allow time to act. Sometimes people don't like the answer that they get, you know, they don't want like it also, so they keep on asking the same question again and again to get a better answer. That happens with me all the time. Happens.
How long, Vanita, you should live? How long you should live? Minimum 6 months, right? Minimum.
No. You can ask after a month or two also, but 3 months is the maximum time you can give to Prashna to materialize, actually. So that is something which is, you know, we must depend. I feel that we must depend on the God, the divine, more rather than, you know, if the results to arrive impatiently, you know, we should depend on him more. That, you know, we are doing that divination work, we are as it is into a divine science. So, you know, this is a divine knowledge. So if you will not, the support of both should be there, then comes the divinity. Only then the divinity comes in. If you will not have that faith, nothing materializes, you know, in astrology.
You said it in the beginning, lesson number one, you said the astrologer is addressing the divinity East, and the divinity, and the same is valid for the people that are coming to you, right?
Yes, and this is something I tell everyone whosoever comes to me. You have to have faith. I am just a medium. I am a via media. I am not the ultimate. I am not the one who will, if something, and you won't believe, Krasi, if I have uttered something positive, it has to happen. Even if it is not in the chart, I can promise you it will happen. Because I have that faith. I have that faith. I believe in him so much that it will. So why not? When you're putting up the query, why not come with that positive frame of mind? Ask a yes question, you will get a yes answer. No question will get a no answer. Sure. So you are all, you have to be on the mercy of him. Not mercy, but receive the mercy of him. So you must realize that, he is the astrologer, not me.
Absolutely. I have absolutely the same approach, Vanita. That's why I like so much to make these conversations and lessons with you, because we are so much on the same track, on the same vibration.
Actually, when we are discussing, Krasi, all this, actually it is a reminder to us also, you see. It is not just that we are a reminder to the viewers. It is a reminder to me also. It is a reminder to you also.
Absolutely.
So this is something... This is something that we are just actually, we want to, this is being humbled, this is being in humility. Humility is the main thing when you are doing astrology. So just coming back to the formulation, please, when will X happen for certain events in life, like getting a job or especially marriage? People just assume that it will happen. So they innocently, ask the Prashna, when will X happen? But this is a false assumption. Please take it. It may never happen also. Instead of asking, when will I get married? You should instead ask, will I get married? Be prepared with those kind of questions rather than, thinking that, no, I need to get married. You have come with that conviction in mind. I have to get married. I will get married. So you already have that. But the Prashna will not be able to answer that kind of query. Yes, there are, obviously, there you will get in the series, you will get to know the timing also. But you see, but it's better to ask, will I get married, right? To start with.
Absolutely.
If the answer looks positive, only then we consider that when it might happen, right? So obviously, if you are not destined to get married or win the lottery, suppose, if somebody comes with that, or become a big superstar or something, those kind of queries, then, then when will it happen? It won't. That becomes absurd, right? So keep it in mind. Don't assume something will happen when you ask a Prashna. Don't assume. Some questions may have options which appear to be like multiple questions, but are actually only one question. You that is also one how you have to formulate it. It has branches. I'll give you an example for that also. So if the questionnaire the questionnaire should try to narrow down those choices as far as possible and understand that the astrologer is also not a fool. That you think that you can play smart on them, then it's not possible. Then it's not possible. So you suppose you come, okay, will I get this job or that job? Should I join this job or that job? There are two options or three options or multiple options, and they will, when should I join? This job is good or not? Will I be successful in this job or not? This is also which is happening. So you have to be very specific in your queries. The option method only relates to choices of actions that you perform and not to the things that might happen to you. So you have to be really careful. So with these pointers, how to ask questions, I think, properly, yes, in a clear and a perfect manner, so that the questions are perfect, the answers are also perfect. So yes, just
structured positive questions.
Yes, yes. So coming to the to your query of multiple questions, how can we do that then? If somebody is asking many questions, so the first Prashna should be from the Lagna. You should get the answer from the Lagna, from the first house. That is the ascendant. All right. if somebody is asking the question, the second question, then you can see it from the moon. You will get the answer from the moon. If somebody is asking the third question, then you should see the state of sun or the sun's position. You will get the answer from the sun. If somebody is asking fourth question, then from Jupiter. If fifth, then which is stronger, Venus or Mercury in the chart? You will get the answer from either of the two. From the sixth, for the sixth Prashna, so you have to see which is weaker, of moon or of Venus or Mercury. Then you can get the answer from there. Then it has been mentioned that a querist is required to ask the Prashna by following a prescribed procedure and prayers and offerings that I just told. So, however, in the present time, no querist restricts himself to one question. So what happened classically, it has been suggested that more than one query may be answered by the following method. That is, which I just gave you. Then you have to what is the rising sign, which I think we have to examine the Lagna. But whether the first house is saying a yes to the first question, only then you should move on to the rest of the moon, sun, Jupiter, Venus or Mercury, or weaker Venus or Mercury. So that is how you have to proceed. If you get the answer from the first house as a positive answer or a negative answer, all right. So if it is connected to the second question, as it will be, or maybe it is not, then you have to see if the ascendant is giving you the answer to the first question correctly or not. Then only you can go ahead with the second Prashna and see the moon. If you have, suppose a moon is a debilitated moon in Scorpio. All right. So what happens if, ascendant is giving you the answer to the first one, but it is negating the second question, which is connected with the first one. By seeing the moon's position, moon is weak when it's debilitated, right? So what happens, you can then go back and see the first question and say that this question is not. So it's better. That is why it is said that you should stick to one question at a time. Stick to one question. If you're asking back to back, then it is likely that there is a negation to the first question also, even if it was a positive answer. You will get another, if you see from the moon's position, it is coming negative. Sorry, the first is also nullified. Yes,
absolutely. Mm-hmm.
So it is something that I wanted to conclude with. So we will be moving on in the next video with something more and something better.
Thank you. No, this was very important. Very important. Thank you so much, Vanita. So you will see us next Sunday with the usual lessons on Prashna, which are really amazing. Yeah. Thank you very much, Vanita, for this treasure. I keep repeating because for me it is a treasure. Thank you very much.
No, it is a treasure for me also. Thank you.
Yes, it is. And I'm using it. And it gives immediately results.
Must. Yes, must.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.